again, and welcome back to the card mat. Right, mental transfer. Yeah, it's not as hard as it looks. You need four aces, or four cards from one coloured packet and four cards from another coloured packet. Make sure, the best idea I could give you is to take them so you've got them one of every suit. Yeah, if you take one of every suit, makes it easier, or a four digit number that you'll know. Like 6529, your bank account or something. That's not mine, by the way. Something that you'll recognise, right? I'm using the four aces and I'm using them in chased order because I'll remember chased order. Have them set up so that they're reversed to each other, as you can see. It doesn't matter which colour goes on the top. It doesn't, right? Start off, show you've got all these aces and split them. Put one packet down, doesn't matter which one, close the other one up, square it, turn it over, spread them, two and two. Because you want to get a break between them two and these two, so it makes it nice and easy. As you're showing the cards, saying these have come out of, say that packet. Square one set up and put yours on, and as you're squaring up, you catch a pinky break at the back. You then pick up these cards and you put them on so that they're covering over your pinky break so it cannot be seen as you're naming what these cards are. You close it up, you turn them over to show that they're a different coloured back. Yeah, it's flashing like crazy there. They're a different coloured back because they've come from a different packet. Turn them over again so they face up and square them up and put them in. I've got more than just one pinky break there. Square them up in like the top corner of the packet, right? Like that, and hold them with your thumb. And you say to your spectator, you want them to mentally think of one of these cards. And you just slide it off with your fingers, palm down. Slide it off with your fingers, show them the card, name it, the Ace of Clubs. Now you're going to put this card underneath these three, but on top of them. So you push up and push it in. Slide off the next card, the Ace of Hearts. This goes the exact same way as the Ace of Clubs. Underneath them, but on top of them. You take off the Ace of Spades. Yay, show them that. Now this goes underneath everything. Don't put it in the break. It goes underneath this packet as well. So when you're bringing it in, make sure that this end edge is covered by the card, because you don't want them seeing it going behind. So you just bring it in there, push it so far down, but leave it stepped a bit, so it can't be seen as behind. You take the next card, the diamond, you turn that over and you put that one right underneath the spade. Now bring your hand to the front because you want to hide all mess at the front and the fact that they'll be able to see as you're sliding it that it's actually a sandwich getting made. So you bring your hand in as you just square the two packets together like that, right? So for those who want to be technical, you've now got two cards in a step break above two cards in a pinky break above two cards in another step break. Yeah, crazy that, isn't it? Dead easy really when you think about it though. And all you're going to do is just close the packets up, but at that pinky break you're going to use your thumb just to slide that packet forward. Once they've closed, slide it forward, pinch it, come and take it into dealer's grip. Right, now the cards which were on the top, i.e. the heart and the club, they're now in this hand. All hearts and clubs. Meaning the diamonds and the spades are in this hand because they were the bottom two cards. Right? So the top ones will end up in this hand. The bottom ones will end up in that hand. If you can't remember that, all you need to do is just get a glimpse of the bottom of one of your packets. I've got a glimpse on that. It's the Ace of Hearts. I know they're in chased order. What comes before the ace? The club. So I've got the club, then the heart. So I know these are going to run spade and diamond. Yeah. So there's the heart, this club right above it. And they're going to run spade and diamond. Chased order. You see what I mean? So you know exactly which card is where. Now, what follows works with any of them. They've thought of a card. Ace of Spades. Well, you know the Ace of Spades is in this packet, right? There's the diamond, there's the spade. You know the Ace of Spades is the second to top card. You now know what move you've got to do to get that Ace of Spades. Right? And we'll get to that when we get to that. You then ask your spectator to pick a packet, and you're doing the magician's force because you want to be keeping hold of this one. So whichever packet they say, you end up with this one. Right? Now, what I'm going to do to this packet, if you do it to that packet, you get the same result because the cards are in the same places. They said the Ace of Hearts instead of the Ace of Diamonds, you do the same move. If they say the Ace of Clubs, where they said the Ace of Spades, you do the same moves. Gets the same results. So I'll put that one down. Right? When you're putting it down, put it down somewhere near to you, because you're going to have to drop a card on that in a minute. Right? So you don't want to be stretching all the way over there. So put the packet down just to the side, out the way sort of thing. Now, because the Ace of Spades is the second to bottom card, you want to do a thing called the never changing count. Yeah, I've shown you the ever changing one. This is the never changing count. It doesn't alter the positions of any card, which means the third card I'm going to show is going to be the blue backed Ace of Spades, right? So you do a magic gesture, your Ace of Spades from that packet is going to appear in this packet. You do the never changing count. Dead easy, honestly. Reverse count the first two cards into your other hand. Then keeping these as one, don't split them. Keeping them as one, you put them into that hand and take the other two back. Right? So they've just seen three cards, third one being a blue. Then you just reverse counting them two back onto the top. Put your finger on that top card, your middle finger on the sticky out blue card, put this finger on the red card, put a finger on the back card, and then just push everything up so your back card comes down on par with that packet, right? Leaving just that one out jogged. You can then strip that out because you can't spread them because you've got a blue one on the bottom. And they said the Ace of Spades. And there you go. Ace of Spades, blue back in the middle of your red packet. Right? Now, before we go into the finale, I'll show you what happened with the Ace of Diamonds. If they say the Ace of Diamonds, you do the ever changing count. Oh, hang on. Before I do that, the never changing count again, I didn't show you, did I? These are spade, diamond, right? Reds, blues. You do the never changing count. So you're peeling off one card, you're peeling off the second card, you're transferring. You're counting and you're counting. Now this should again leave me with ace diamonds, spades, diamonds, spades, diamonds. Spades, diamonds, spades, diamonds. Never changes the order, right? If they said the ace of diamonds, you do the ever changing count where you're taking one card off, catching that one card back as you strip off the double. I'm trying to do it so you can see slightly. Strip off the double, get a break between them two cards as you push the blue card off and take that card that you just got your break on back with that one. So they've now seen three cards, a third one being a blue one, and you reverse count them two. Do the same thing, up jog it and pull it out, and the Ace of Diamonds has got the blue back. Yay! Magic, innit? But that does alter the order of your top two cards. Ever changing, it changes them and changes them, right? Yeah, that's right now. So there you go. So once you've done it, I'll show you with this one that it works just the same with this one. They say the Ace of Clubs, I want to do the never changing. So I'll peel one off, I'll peel two off, I'll put that down, take them two back, and I'll reverse count them two, and I'll do that, and I'll pull that out, and the Ace of Clubs has got the blue, the red back. Right, now, the pack you weren't using would be down beside you. You just pulled out a red backed card, which happened to be the one that they'd named, right? But you left dirty. You got a red card on the bottom of two blue ones, and you got two blue cards on the bottom of two red ones, right? So all you're going to do is, while they're oohing and over that, you're going to steal the bottom card. So all you're going to do is use them fingers just to go shoof and push it out. When you got your hand there, you're squaring up. And you just go shoof. Oh, I'll bring my hand in a bit. You go shoof and push it out. And then you're just pulling your hand away with that card palmed in your hand. And you're going to drop it onto them ones as you pick them up and put them onto the top of there. Very, very casually like. Right? Don't draw no attention to it. Do it very, very casual. Then you can say, so you there's the red ace of clubs, there's the red back heart, there's the red back spade, there's the red back diamond, and here's the four blue ones. And you end up clean as a whistle. One of them. Yeah. So ever changing count, never changing count, and a bottom palm, and you're away. Happy days. I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you very, very much for watching, and I will see you again soon.